Cash, dollars, dollars, that's all that I want. I need a bag full of it in the trunk. Give me plenty, I can't get enough. I flip a couple stacks, then I double up. Ay, pretty spiffy, cost me a pretty penny. Right off of the rack, up to the tippy tippy. Look exactly how I feel, and I feel like a mill. No more talking till they cut the deal. Hi fairies, welcome back to my channel. I'm giving you guys another It's Giving video. You guys are loving this series and I am so glad and I'm just so happy. And the love you guys have been giving me, it's just really pumping me up, amping your girl up. This time I actually have some sort of a picture for y'all. I was thinking of doing two kinds of colors, like purple and pink. So the same thing goes for every single It's Giving video. I'm gonna be showing you guys a color palette that I'm gonna be going off of. Telling you guys which colors, what colors I'm gonna be mixing together, so on and so forth. So I'm gonna be mixing these two colors together. This color is Orchid, this color is Intense Purple, both of which is from Kiss Temptations. This color is Pink Petal from Kiss Temptations. This color is Vivid Violet from Kiss Temptations. And then these two colors are from Arctic Fox. This is their new shade, Frosé. And then this is their older shade, Periwinkle. So like I said, I never have a clue of how I'm gonna be placing the colors onto the wig. The main thing I just like to do is first start with my color selection. And then as I'm putting the colors on a wig, that's usually when I start to have my creative thoughts come to me. So the first colors I'm gonna start with are Orchid and the Intense Purple, which are these two colors right here. I'm gonna start first by mixing together my main base color. So I know definitely I want these two colors to be my main base of the entire wig. So Intense Purple and Orchid, I'm just gonna scoop, scoop right in this bowl, y'all. I do have the wig already sectioned off of what I wanna do. This hair is from Chambray Hair. This is their Raw Indian Blonde. I have four bundles of 20 inch. I wanted this wig to be super thick. I have four bundles fit into a 13x6 20 inch frontal. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put my gloves on and start to apply the color to the wig. Y'all know I have a specific way of putting my colors on my wigs, but as I do in every single video, if I have to say any detailed tips or why I do certain things, I will definitely let you guys know in captions inside the video. To change this whole entire game, I'm gonna put all the colors that I would have put on the ends to the roots, because I know a really good trend right now is doing colors on the roots. This color is pretty dark. If I was to take that color and put it on the roots, most likely it's going to come to the ends of the hair. I would try my best not to, but you know, most of the times it ends up going to the ends of the hair, and it would just make the process so much easier if I just had the lighter color at the root part and then this darker color at the end. So let me just start by doing that process in this middle part and starting with the color Vivid Violet.
So I'm gonna move on to the next section. I meant to do this color all the way up into here, but I ran out of that color and I only had one bottle. I'm going to instead, for this part, I'm gonna use the color Pink Petal from Kiss Temptations. I already have it poured in my little bowl, and then I'm going to put the intense purple and the orchid on the bottom, just like how I layered and ombre'd this drawing. So let's get started. And mix Girls Night from Arctic Fox and Orchid from Kiss Color Temptation together. They're literally like the same color. This is a liquid formula, this is a cream formula. Mix them together to come out with it's like a lavendery purple color, and place that color on this side, and then do the orchid and the intense purple mixture on the bottom. I hope it doesn't sound like too complicated, but per use, just go ahead and watch me paint to see my color placements so that you guys understand me a lot more. Moving on to the last portion of the wig, I have it sectioned off in different types of sections. Y'all know sectional hair is kind of my thing or whatever. I have about four. I have four sections here. So what I'm thinking about doing for this one is, I just feel like if I just pull like a dark color right here, because the other colors that we're putting over here are going to be so light, that darker plum purple like right here in the middle, because we have the other lighter colors on this side, I feel like it's going to make the wig pop, just that little added like that it really needs, you know what I'm saying? I hope that makes a little bit of sense, y'all. But if that doesn't make any sense to y'all, then of course y'all can just watch and see what your girl do, okay? Okay, guys, so I'm just going to continue to rinse out this wig, and then I'm just going to shampoo and condition it. I'm going to be using the Ion Color Defense shampoo. Make sure that you're using this specific shampoo because this is why my color doesn't rinse out. A lot of you guys were asking me in my last video, how did I shampoo, actually in my Cardi B video, how did I shampoo and condition a hair and none of the color came out? That's because I use this one. This one is really good for gently cleansing the hair without stripping out the color. That's why I specifically use this one from Ion. If you use a regular shampoo, it's most likely going to wash the color out. But if you use one that's good for colored hair, it won't. And then I'm going to condition it with this Ion Intense Moisture Conditioner just to bring added moisture back to the hair and just make sure that when I'm conditioning the hair, again, I'm using Color Safe Conditioner. High on life, took too much. You're still here after touch, after touch. You're still here after touch, after touch.
Moving on to doing the styling portion of this video. So this is a hair air dried, and I have to say, when I was looking at this wig and blow drying it and just seeing all the different color dimensions and all that or whatever, I was just like, oh my god, I seriously snapped. And I was just like, you know, I'm getting back in my groove, y'all. Like, I'm getting better and better and better. I felt like with the Keisha Cole wig for the first one, it was my first wig dipping and dabbing and getting back into, like, you know, the whole swing of things. And now I feel like I'm getting my momentum back and I'm just feeling real good. Like, a girl is on a high horse right now. Not too high, but just like, okay, we out here, we back in it, you know what I'm saying? So all I did was go ahead and blow dry the hair. You guys already know I only like to really blow dry my hair when the hair is about 80% to 90% already dry, just because it just brings out a whole different texture of the hair and the weaves. So yeah, I'm just going ahead and blow drying the hair. I will move on to straightening and hot combing the frontal, plucking it, and then you guys already know I'm going to be doing long waves. So I'm not going to be cutting this hair at all today. I'm actually leaving it as is, but I do go ahead and curl the hair and show y'all the hair up close and personal, and then I finish ending with some pin curls. Thank you. Like I do in every single video, I'm going to be doing my install on camera for y'all so y'all can see this up close and personal chambray frontal. Like I said, I am using a 13x6 transparent chambray frontal that I use the Erica J lace tint in medium brown to tint. And I feel like this is definitely like my best install up to date because just the way I blended this lace into this hairline, y'all gonna see later on. But I'm just gonna be using the Got to Be Insta Hold spray. Y'all already know I have a video out on YouTube already giving y'all the tea about this spray. This has been my favorite spray. I have not put it down within the past year in some change. And yeah, as far as the makeup in this video, like I said, my videos were already done prior to me making an entire series and stuff on this channel. My wig colors and all that stuff was already like done. Like the video was already set in stone. My outfits were already picked out and all that stuff. It was not planned for me to do makeup portions in the video because the videos were literally already done. I know for my next season, you know, this is definitely season one. I'm giving y'all season two within the next couple of weeks. I felt like the first season, it was pretty cute. It was nice. It was a good intro to the series and it was a good intro to me coming back on YouTube. Thank y'all so much for all the love y'all have been showing within the past couple of weeks and days on my social media as well as my YouTube comments. I read every single comment that you guys write. I will definitely start getting better as far as responding to you guys, but y'all have been showing me so much love and I swear for my first time coming back, it just feels so freaking good. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Definitely make sure y'all wait until the end because I'm about to be serving y'all this look, honey. This purple is giving me everything. But yes, thank y'all so much and I love you guys. Bye. Trip.